Hey guys, today's video is going to be my current favorites. I don't typically do it very often just because I don't really, try lots of products. So I did used to try to do it like every 2 months, but then I was like, I don't want to force myself to actually really like products. So I decided to just do them whenever I accumulate a good enough amount for every so often. So let's just go ahead and get started. I'm going to start off with like weird products or whatever. And the first product I want to talk about is this conditioner by Pantene. This is the Sheer Volume Conditioner, the Thick Full Body for 24 Hours, the purple one. I actually saw Sarah Rae Vargas here on YouTube trying it out, and she said that she really liked it, that her hair had nice volume, it was drying nicely, so I tried it. And I really do like it. I've tried several conditioners and shampoos that say tame frizz and da 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 da. But this is actually the one thing that I don't have to put like extra product in my hair in order for it to actually like stay flat like this. Well, it's not flat. I feel like it has nice volume and everything. I actually like my hair how it looks when it's dry. Usually I don't. I always hate the way it looks dry because it's always frizzy and poofy and blah 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 blah. But this has really been working with my hair. Like, my main problem area is like right here up front, but I actually don't mind washing my hair and then going letting it air dry. I honestly don't mind the way it looks. So this has been my best friend lately. And the good thing is that it's inexpensive, so I don't have to pay like $30 for a conditioner. The next thing I want to talk about is pretty random, but I typically have problems like I used to have problems trying to like have my foundation match my body because I didn't know whether to match to my chest or to my arms or what the heck. So I bought this St. Marie's Instant Self Tanning Mousse in the shade Dark. I saw a lot of people like raving about this product, so I did try it, and I do love that more the tan it gives my chest to kind of match the rest of my body. But I've decided that I'm just going to match my foundation to my chest. And I constantly wonder how come tan people can't get like a self tanner. Because I mean, what if there's tan people that want to get darker, you know? So I kind of feel like this is as dark, like this is dark. And I feel like it's kind of just like almost like a shade darker than me. So that's like kind of sucky. So, and then I thought of like going to an actual tanning salon to actually go get my body the same color. But I'm just going to match my body, my foundation to the rest of my, like my neck right here. I'm just going to match it right here and put bronzer on, and that's good because finally a Sephora lady told me exactly what to do, because usually they're just like, oh, match your arms or try right here or like whatever. But then she actually gave me good details and information. So shout out to her. I really don't know her name, which sucks. But anyways, to the next one. I always do it, but Kathleen Lights in the span of from the last favorites I did, which I don't remember, from the last one, she did release two nail polish collections. One was the fall collection, like the 70s one, and then the next one was the nude, the lips and tips collection, which out of the two, I honestly prefer the lips and tips one because I love me some nudes. Right now, it looks really janky, but right now I'm wearing, I believe, November, and I've tried Aquarius. Aquarius is so beautiful, and I've tried Point Zero. I haven't tried Taurus, and my sister, Daisy, stop. My sister actually tried Alyssa, and it looks so pretty on her, and she is lighter than me. But I honestly love her Lips and Tips collection with ColourPop. It's so beautiful. So the next thing I want to talk about are a couple of face products. And the first one I want to talk about is the MAC Prep and Prime Fix Plus. I did buy like the sample size at Ulta, which, oh my gosh, guys, I honestly really do like it. It's kind of up there with my Smashbox Primer Water. I don't know what it is about this, but it really like melts everything into my skin, and I do really think it helps make my makeup last. I need to compare it, but I seriously have been gravitating towards this all the time. Whenever I want to like get rid of the powdery look or set my face or whatever, I really, really enjoy this, and I feel like it dries quickly, so you're not just sitting there for a long time trying to like wait for your face to dry. But guys, this is really good. If you're a bit like on the fence, I do definitely recommend getting the small bottle, because I think the bigger bottle is like, what, $30 or $40? I'm not really sure, but like, I've got this like a while back, and this is how much I've used. Plus, I do use my Smashbox one, but like, guys, I definitely recommend this. And then I have two primers. One is the Makeup Forever Step 1 Skin Equalizer. This has been amazing. This has been a game changer for me, guys. Like, I used to think, man, my skin's so dry. Oh my gosh, I need all these dewy primers or moisturizing primers. But then I would do that, and I'm like, why am I constantly getting oily? And it's because I have combination skin. So right here on the outside, I'm dry, and in the T-zone, I get pretty oily. So I kept trying to find like pore filling primers, because that's what I saw that was recommended for more oily type skin. And then I tried a couple, and this one right here has been hands down my favorite. You just need a very little. You put it right there where your oily areas are, and it is very pore filling, I believe so. It does for me, like, it really smooths my skin out and everything. And I just put a little bit in my T-zone, and it is like good to go. And then the next one I really have been enjoying is the Smashbox Photo Finish Foundation Primer. This is the clear one, the OG. And guys, this is the first one I tried before the Makeup Forever one, and I really, really enjoyed this one. The thing with this one is that it's more like pore filling than it is like keeping your oils at bay. This one really, really helps control my oils, and this one it does, but after a while I do start to see my nose get more oily before this one. The next product I want to talk about are these blushes that I've had for a while, and these are the Tarte Amazonian Clay 12-Hour Blushes. They are so freaking beautiful. I have the shades Vibrant, Genius, Pop, Royal, and True Love. They are all so beautiful, like, guys. And what I love the most about these blushes is the fact that they're matte. This came in this little like bundle set with the brush, this one right here, that is also included in this month's my favorites. This blush brush, guys, I love it so freaking much. And the thing is that Kathleen actually recommended this to me, and then she's like, oh, it's limited edition, it's no longer in stock. And then I was on Tarte during their sales, and they had this brush with all these blushes as a bundle, which I can't find anymore. I'm so sorry, guys. But guys, their blushes are really, really nice. They're so soft. They're a good amount of pigmented, not pigmented where you're like, oh man, I need to like really blend this out, or oh man, I put too much. It's just so beautiful and soft and blendable and buildable. Everything about these are just so beautiful. They kind of, in a way, remind me, not even, I was gonna say they kind of remind me of the like Flower Beauty and like Milani blushes, but somehow these are different. So the next like face product I'm gonna talk about is the Hourglass Vanish Stick Foundation. I bought this, guys. I was like, I hear so much great things about it, and I was like, okay, let me just try it, whatevs. And I have the shade Golden Tan, which I have had to like exchange it a few times to finally find my real shade. I was actually going to go darker until, you know, the professional Sephora lady told me to stick with this one. What I can say about this one is that, honestly, guys, I thought I was going to hate it, because, you know, I feel like every foundation is like the exact same thing. But this one, guys, it leaves my skin like so flawless. It blends beautifully. It's like a medium coverage, because I have this mole right here. And if I can still see that mole, that means, or like a little bit, that means it's kind of medium coverage. But it's a beautiful medium coverage. Like, I feel like you can build it up in certain places if you want to. And I do prefer, honestly, I have tried several brushes for like foundation, and I swear, nothing yet has been able to satisfy that. Like, I swear, like, beauty blenders are just it for me. This blends out so easily, like, just da 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 da, you're done. It's so magical, and I just really love it. And the thing, honestly, I think what I love the most is that I just go zoom 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 zoom. I don't have to like pump it out, dot all over my face, keep dotting it, and then have a mess all over me. So this is so beautiful, you guys. And the thing with this is that it doesn't make me feel like I get oilier. I don't feel like I have a problem when I with my oils when I wear this foundation. So the next product I want to talk about is this Maybelline Eye Studio Eyeliner. And this is in the shade Black is Black. And the reason I actually picked this up is from a long, 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 long time ago. I remember Jaclyn Hill talking about this and this being her favorite eyeliner. And I've got to say, guys, this eyeliner is really beautiful. And it's about $8 at the drugstore. And it's just a pot, just like that. If it was the Anastasia Brow Pomade, it looks exactly like it. And I don't like the brush because the brush is too thick and it creates very thick lines. But if you're a pro, I'm pretty sure you can handle that. But this eyeliner is so black, so matte. It's so beautiful, for a wing eyeliner to put in your waterline to tight line. It's just the perfect kind. And if you're really good at these kind of eyeliners, I definitely recommend you picking it up. It's so beautiful. But what I can say is that when I try to take it off with a wipe or anything, I kind of have to rub a little bit because it's so stuck on there. It's not budging, which is good. But I'm just saying you gotta kind of work a little bit to take it off. The next product I want to talk about is my game changer. And this is the Tarte Lights Camera Lashes Mascara. It's the guys, it's the purpley crocodile looking mascara. This mascara, guys, I can wear, I can actually say this is my favorite mascara so far. I thought the L'Oreal Carbon Black one was it for me. I thought the Lash Paradise. I thought the Better Than Sex one. I thought all of these. But then when I tried this, guys. This is so beautiful. It makes my lashes, my lashes are so stubborn, guys. When I say stubborn, I mean stubborn. And it just really, really works for my lashes. My lashes always, they can't hold the curl. They're short and stubby. And this makes them long. It doesn't get clumpy. And if I ever put too much, I use my little lash comb. But it doesn't make my lashes clumpy at all. It makes them long and voluminous. And I'm okay with just wearing this with eyeshadow. Guys, if you have stubborn eyelashes, this is a need, definitely. So another product I want to talk about is the ColourPop Brow Buzz, which I just did a video on not too long ago. I think this week, I posted a video comparing it to the Morphe Eyebrow Pencil, which, guys, I'm going to tell you, I love these. This is very affordable. I believe they're actually both $7, which I think in the video I said that there were different prices. But I have the shade Dark Brown. I don't actually have my eyebrows done. I don't have anything on my face, guys. I was just editing a video and I was let me record a video now. So I really enjoy this right here. It's so beautiful. It's just I'm not going to talk about it too much because I really, really do love it. And I will link the video in one of those corners so you can watch it, so you can know how it is, how it performs and everything. But yeah, guys, definitely recommend. So the lip products I've been liking, or loving really, are the Bare Minerals liquid lipsticks. I think these are the velvet ones, or the soft velvet ones. And I have the shades XYZ and the shade Weekend. This is the shade XYZ. It's such a beautiful nude. Look at that, guys. Oh, I don't know why these kind of remind me of the Kylie liquid lipsticks. And this is in the shade Weekend. This one's more pinky and this one's more peachy nude, which I actually prefer XYZ. But they're so beautiful. They're so soft, and I really hate my lips when they feel dry. So they're very soft. They're not drying at all. They're not completely matte. They will transfer. So I kind of want to say they're kind of a satin velvet liquid lip. But they're so beautiful, and I really like the way they smell. They smell really good. They kind of remind me of cookies. So the next lip product that's literally in my bag, I had to take it out of my bag right now, is this Lorac Alter Ego Hydrating Lip Stain in the shade Secret Agent. Guys, this is my everyday lip color. It's that one right there. That is so freaking beautiful. I should have swatched it for you. But honestly, guys, it's not super pigmented. You do have to run your lips along it. Let me try it for you. Look at that. I love it so freaking much. It's just so natural, and I put it on like if my like one if one of these liquid lipsticks like go away or vanishes, I pick that up, put that on because it goes with every single one of my makeup looks, especially because I'm pretty basic. But this is so beautiful. It's like a glossy, almost more of a satin kind of finish. So I've been obsessed with three eyeshadow palettes. Well, actually, I just gave it away because one of them is this one. So four. And the first eyeshadow palette I want to talk about is this Tarte Clay Play Face Shaping Palette. And it looks like dish. Ugh. And honestly, I just had a little bit of a malfunction if you would have saw my past holiday makeup look. All of these shades I can wear. All of these shades I can make amazing looks. I can bronze, maybe do a little bit of contouring. And this shade is just too gray for me, not working for me. But honestly, guys, if I want just like to just quickly put something, and then it has a black, it has browns, it has light colors, it has like this really pretty like satiny. Oh, this one. It has this really pretty satiny shade. Ugh. I just swatched on the lipstick. Oh my gosh, I'm horrendous. But it's so freaking beautiful, guys. Like, I definitely recommend this if you are a beginner. You have your contour shades and your eyeshadow shades, perfect for you guys. The next palette I want to talk about is the Too Faced Just Peachy Mattes, which looks like this, which I'm pretty sure you all have seen. This eyeshadow palette has gone viral. These are colors are so beautiful, and it smells like peaches, guys. It smells so good. Not like an overwhelming scent, but it just smells good. Like you have be this can create so many eye looks. I mostly create neutral ones, but then usually I put like these more almost maroony, burgundy, like deep purpley shades in the outer corner to give it more of a like purpley, smoky eye instead of a brown one. And then you put some of these all over the lid, and they're just so beautiful, so matte, so pigmented, but in a good way. They're so soft, they're so blendable. Beautiful. The next one I want to talk about is one that I used in a previous, holiday makeup tutorial, which it's the Pixie Plus. It's Judy Time eyeshadow palette, and it looks like this. Guys, if you want a more affordable neutral eye eyeshadow palette, this is it. Especially, you can find Pixie at Target. I believe this is about $24, but it's so beautiful. Like, you have shimmery shades, you have a satin shade, you have lots of mattes, you have two darker, like, shimmery shades. And then more dark mattes. The black one does have glitter in it, but when you like pick it up and like tap it off the excess, like most of the glitter comes out. It doesn't really translate on the lid. And this stuff is so soft, guys. I didn't think I was actually gonna like it that much. I don't know why. I've never really tried like Pixi makeup products because they really don't go for my skin tone. So when I picked this, I was like, it's gonna be sucky. I'm not gonna like it, but I'm a sucker for neutral palettes. The last product I want to talk about is this Huda Beauty Smoky Obsessions eyeshadow palette. Guys, this is, I believe, $27. And honestly, I thought this was going to be 10 times bigger than this, like, eyeshadow palette. I mean, do you see my hand? It's like the size of my palm, guys. I thought it was going to be like the size of my hand. I seriously thought it was going to be bigger. And so when I saw it, I was like, why is this so small? Here are some metallics. Oh boy! Here's a matte shade, and here's another matte shade. I mean, look at that, guys. I don't really like to judge eyeshadow off of their finger swatches because, like, when you do it on the eye, they're completely different. But, guys, just looking at those swatches, like, obviously, you can use your fingers for these more metallic shades. But the metallic shades, guys, they're so beautiful. That's so beautiful. If you really want to try Huda Beauty, try these mini palettes. I actually have the like the really bright neon ones, but I haven't tried it, so that's why it's not included in here. But hopefully it's just as good. And I was gonna include it because I'm like, they're the same eyeshadow, same brand. But sometimes like very neon shades are more like kind of like what's the word? Patchy and stuff like that. So I wasn't really sure and I didn't want to just include it and it's actually garbage. So yeah, guys, those are all my current favorites right now. I know it was a lot, but I'm so glad I went ahead and did it right now instead of doing it like last time when I had like 10 million favorites. So I hope you enjoyed this video. Let me know what have been your current favorites. Let me know what products you want me to try. Let me know what videos you want to see. Don't forget to subscribe, guys. Like, if you love me, you'll subscribe. Like, I'm a pretty decent person. Subscribe. So anyways, guys, thanks so much for watching. And I'll see you in my next video. Bye, guys.